We went to three different beaches, and each of them were very different. After long clinic days, the water was so refreshing and exactly what we needed after a long clinic day. Fountain Blue was definitely a highlight of my week. The Haitian people want us to see the beauty of Haiti and not just the poverty. The Fountain Blue was linked to three waterfalls. The water was bluer than the sky and refreshing in 90-degree weather. We jumped off cliffs and swam for hours, and no words could truly explain what it was like.
Who's disturbing? Hi, I'm Lindsey. For senior experience, I had the opportunity to travel to Mexico along with 15 other students. We did service on Refuge Ranch, a ranch that provides a home for 18 children. We spent the week constructing cement and plastering walls for a new house so their family can grow and continue to help abandoned children. There were a few nights of the week that our entire group met and talked about what we had been experiencing. Each person had an opportunity to share how they were feeling. This time provided us with a way to express our emotions and also learn how the trip was impacting others around us. Many people shared about how they noticed happiness. They realized that this family had so much less than we do, and yet they had this contagious happiness to them. Someone asked why we have been blessed with the life that we have while this family wasn't blessed in the ways that we are. I never shared my thoughts in the time that we were given because I was never able to completely put my thoughts together. I felt something different. I disagreed with the questions that were being asked. I didn't believe that we were the blessed ones in this situation, and I never once asked why this family wasn't blessed with the things that we were blessed with. Instead, I found myself jealous of the life that this family was living. It was simple and it was easy. They woke up every morning and did devotionals as a family and prayed before each and every meal that they ate together. They opened their home to over 20 strangers, and they didn't care if we walked through their house with dirty, dusty shoes on. This family realized the true value in the life that they had been given. They wake up each day grateful for what God has given them, not ungrateful because others have been given more. To me, they live a more blessed life than I ever will. I want to be happy more than anything in my life, and it's the most cliche answer when someone asks me what I want, but it's unquestionably and undeniably true. Everyone wants to be happy and content, and we are fully aware of the people, events, and feelings that make us happy, yet we resist them. Matthew Kelly, the author of Resisting Happiness, once wrote, "We live in a culture that says the meaning of life is to get what we want, and that when we get what we want, then we will be happy. We yearn for happiness because we are created for it. So we fall for the lie. We race off into the world to get what we want, but sooner or later, we realize that getting what we want does not make us happy. This Mexico trip taught me that the culture I live in feeds me distorted information of what will make me happy. The world wants me to believe that materialistic things will make me happy. It wants me to believe that the earthly possessions I desire will bring me happiness, but I've come to realize there's an imperative difference between the happiness the world brings us and the happiness that is given to us by the Father. Earthly happiness is temporary, while God-given happiness is eternal. Happiness that comes from God comes from within, not from the overpriced materialistic objects we buy because the world tells us we need them. Our culture constantly tells us that we need more. We do not need more. We do not need more than what is essential to live. But we are consumed with the thoughts of having more and more until we are obsessed with the temporary happiness each minuscule object brings us. When we are filled with eternal happiness, our worlds are changed forever. The feeling of eternal happiness far surpasses the momentary sensation that comes from man-made happiness. Eternal happiness lives in us and through us, and it lasts a copious amount longer than any happiness this world is capable of giving. The Zaragoza family taught me that we all need to be grateful for the life that God has given us. I need to learn how to find true happiness in my life, and the Zaragoza family was a role model for how I need to start living my own life. When I look at what I've been given, there's no reason why I should not wake up with a smile on my face every day and be absolutely grateful for every blessing that God has put in my life. There is no reason I should not be happy. I'm incredibly grateful for this opportunity that I got to experience this trip, and I've learned so much more than I ever thought I would. Each person was a blessing to me and taught me how to fully live my life for the Lord each and every day. I want to leave you this verse, 1 Thessalonians 5:16-18. Rejoice always, pray continually, and give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus.
I'm Jeremy, and like Lindsey, I had the opportunity to travel with 15 of my friends to what would be a life-changing trip to Refuge Ranch in Mexico. I've been looking forward to this trip for quite some time since my mom started leading trips to Mexico for senior experience in 2009. I had talked to my brother and sister and some others that had gone on the trip in the past about what to expect. The answers that kept coming up were, I should expect a lot of hard work, I should expect a lot of amazing food, I should expect to fall in love with the kids, and I should expect to feel very different about Mexico when I leave. I can say without a doubt that all of those things were 100% true. One of the things that really stuck with me on this trip was the kids. Compared to our standards, they don't have a whole lot, but these kids were some of the happiest kids I've ever met. They had no problem inviting 20 people into their home, and they had no problem sharing whatever they had to make sure that their guests felt comfortable. I tried to put myself in their shoes, and there's no way that I could be half as happy as they were. We live in a society where we always need more, and we are never satisfied with These kids were completely content with what they had and didn't take anything for granted, which was something I was completely amazed by. Another example of pure happiness was the head worker at the ranch named Serena. He lived in a 20 by 20 house with a dirt floor and tarps for walls with his wife and three children. He gets up every day of the year and works harder than anyone I've ever met. Although he had to put up with 15 teenagers all week and probably had to fix half the stuff we did after we left, I never saw him without a smile on his face. He had all the skill and knowledge to build a much more livable house than he currently had, but he is completely content with his way of living. How is it that someone that has so much less than us can be so much more happy than us? It's the people that you would least expect to learn things from that you can learn the most from. With that being said, there were so many things that I learned from this week, but the one thing that has stuck with me the most is to be thankful for the life that I've been given. Everybody grows up in different situations, some good, some not so good, and you can't always control them. But the one thing you can control is your attitude towards your situation. I learned to make the most of whatever situation you are put in. I wouldn't trade the lessons I've learned on this trip for the world, and I'm beyond thankful that I was able to have this experience with many of my friends. Thank you.
Thanks to each one of you for sharing and reflecting, and I'm sure that your experiences will continue to challenge you as you think about how to incorporate what you learned, what you saw, what you experienced into your life now and in the future. I'll take Lindsey's invitation.